this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Today I'm on yet another field trip. This is one of my favorite field trips to take. I'm currently traveling in Maui, having fun underneath the sun. And whenever I travel, you know, for you guys and for myself, I like to learn about agriculture and how to grow food more sustainably. So I found a great resource here, and we're in actually Lahaina, Maui, and we're here actually at the Makai Inn. And the Makai Inn has, basically I learned about it online, and they do backyard aquaponics. And I know several of you guys want to learn more about aquaponics. Say, John, do an episode on aquaponics. So I found out about it, and I'm here, and we're gonna show you more about aquaponics today. So we're standing here with the great Pacific Ocean right behind me, because this, the Makai Inn is on the ocean, basically. So you could stay at an oceanfront place and be able to look out the ocean and all the boats in the background. But aside from that, this is a pretty cool place to stay at. You know, they were telling me they have a compost bins that they collect regularly, actually to feed to their worms. And also the worms actually go into the aquaponics, so it's definitely part of a system. This is the kind of place that you want to come if you want to relax. You don't want to party, you want to just relax. There's no TVs here, no phones, but they do have internet. So, and so you can still watch Growing Your Greens when you're in Hawaii. So these are the worms that actually go into the aquaponic system. You know, I thought that aquaponics was just basically fish and plants, but you know what? They found that they need to have worms in there too, because worms contribute to the whole system of aquaponics. So here we are looking at basically a Worm Factory 2000 right here. And this is where they, you know, he puts all the compost and it feeds the worms. You could drain off the worm tea, of course, down at the bottom over here. And there's all these, you know, different trays, and oh, there's some of the worms down there. And the other thing he's using for, you know, if you don't want to spend a bunch of money on the Worm Factory, which is great, you could just use pretty much, this is simply a wine shipping box that they ship wines at. And if you have a local Costco, Costco will often get the wines in these boxes, and you could grab like a box if it's like empty, wooden box. You could also use this as a planter to start plant your starts in, plant seeds in as well. So most people would just like put the food and stuff on top to feed the worms. And what he does, and I never saw this anywhere, is he has a PVC pipe with holes drilled into it, and he puts the food in there and then covers it with like a, looks like a nut top from a can of nuts. That way the worms go into the middle to feed, then they go back outside, I guess, when they're not feeding. This way he doesn't attract the flies and the birds and maybe like rats, because, you know, the food is in a covered area. The other thing that was really cool that I learned about today is one of the best uses of soda. So here we have some cola, but the best use of soda is not to put it in our bodies, because, you know, it's full of all kinds of sugars and, you know, it's basically just sugar water stuff. But you know what? He told me the worms love it. So we're gonna go ahead and pour this into his worm bin, a little bit in there, and we're gonna pour the cola in here. And that is probably one of the best uses of cola. Feed your worms. So we're here in the courtyard at the Makai Inn, and this is where it all happens. They have a nice, beautifully landscaped area. They have the aquaponics set up over there, which we're gonna check out in a minute. But before we check that out, actually what we're gonna do now is we're gonna actually look at some of the food that the fish are fed. And you could grow the food really easy. This is called duckweed. So let's come over here and we'll show you the containers of duckweeds growing in. So here's a 40-gallon feed tub or aqua tank, basically filled with water. Actually, it has the water from the fishes that have some of the nutrients in there. And what they're doing in here is growing azolla or duckweed. So what they do is they, you know, come over and they scoop it all together. And they could pick this up and get a whole bunch of this stuff. And this is azolla or duckweed. This is a very nutritious green. It's used to feed the tilapia fish, but also other farmers actually grow this stuff, and it multiplies and grows really fast in water to feed things like chickens and goats and ducks. So yeah, duckweed, the ducks love it, and so do the fish. And you could probably grow it too real easy. So next, let's go over and check out the aquaponics setup. So we're in the courtyard of the Makai Inn, and this is where they have the aquaponics system. This is probably the only inn that I know of in the world so far that has an aquaponics system. And the goal of the aquaponics system is actually to grow food for the people that are coming and staying at the inn. So the people staying at the inn to go out every day and harvest their food. So this is their introductory system where they've been learning on how to perfect and master the art of aquaponics, and pretty soon they're gonna have a much larger system on the side of the building to grow a substantial amount of food for the visitors to the inn, and I think that's gonna be awesome. This is gonna be like an eco-tourism destination here in Lahaina, Maui. Anyways, let's go ahead and talk about this system here behind me. We're gonna go over each component in a minute, but the basics is this. Right behind me, they have a big tub, and this is like commercial quality tub. And of course, you guys at home, you guys wanna do this on a small scale, you could even use something like a, you know, kids swimming pool, you know, that's kind of what this looks like to me, but this is much larger. And you know, he spent, definitely is an investment to make all this, buying things and, you know, all the parts from the feed store, you know, because these are feed troughs, basically, and PVC piping, which isn't too expensive. Oh, and before I forget, the one thing that's really important is you want to use at least a minimum 1.5-inch to 2-inch PVC pipe. He tried to do a smaller experimental system with a smaller piping, and it just didn't work too well. But this right here is basically a 300-gallon tank. He currently has about 80 tilapias in there, as well as some mosquito fish, which we'll get a close-up in a minute, and that's just to basically eat any mosquito larvae that may, you know, land in there. But the tilapia do all the work. They basically produce fertilizer or fish poop for the plants. The water is basically siphoned up into the 40-gallon feed tubs up there, and he has a variety of different plants, lots of vegetables, some herbs growing as well. This is a 300-gallon tub with all the water, and he has this covered because, you know, you don't want to get, you know, things like rain. If rain comes into the system, it could mess up the pH and the balance and throw the nutrients off, actually. So he has this all covered. Plus, this is, you know, an inn, and people walking by may throw things, debris or whatever, and he doesn't want to get that into the system. He wants to keep it as clean as possible. So we're going to go ahead and lift up this this plank here that covers it, and you can see all the tilapia in this 300-gallon tub here swimming around. And, you know, optimally, this is all going to be, the fish are going to be fed by the duckweed that's produced on site. And currently, he's still in the learning process, as we all are in gardening. And, you know, if you think you could just start an aquaponic system and do it from zero to being 100% efficient and doing it right the first time, you know what, you're in for a special treat. Because even in gardening, you know, there's a learning curve. And I would suggest, as always, to learn as you grow. And it's easiest to model nature, and nature grows in, you know, dirt and soil, and that's how I started growing. But slowly I'm gonna get into things like aquaponics as I master the craft, or fairly well master the craft of growing in soil. Then I can take it to the next level and play around and experiment with growing aquaponics. And I think aquaponics is a great solution overall, because, I mean, you're making your fertilizer and you have the fish as a resource as well. So you could sell them to others that want to have aquaponics. You could use the fish. You could also use the fish as a fertilizer. So, I mean, most people buy fish emulsion, which are basically, fish emulsion is a nice word for ground up dead fish. So you could take some fish, and, you know, here in Hawaii, they just take fish and bury it in the ground, and they would plant a tree where they bury that dead fish. And that is the fertilizer for the tree, and, you know, worms would come and eat the fish and then poop out worm castings, and that's how nature works. So the system is basically, you know, a high-tech way of duplicating what nature would do. So this is all the fish here. You can see all these different pipes and everything going in and out, and one pipe is sucking the water up into the 40-gallon tubs to basically water the plants. The other pipe basically gets it to drain out. So next, let's go ahead and look at the tubs, see what's growing, and talk a little bit more about the aquaponic system here at the Makai Inn. So we're so lucky they're adding on to the aquaponic system today, so we're here to see some of the construction. And basically, it's easy as clearing some of the area. They put down some blocks and raised it up with some wood, and now they just put these big 40-gallon troughs in. And their next step is they're gonna start to drill the holes to where they need the holes to get all the PVC plumbing in. And really, you know, it's just like building old Legos when you're a kid. Next, we're gonna talk about what do you fill the big tubs with, you know, in the aquaponic system. Well, the main thing it's filled with is basically some gravel. And this is a, I think it was like 3/4 gravel. They're fairly large, and this happens to be lava gravel. But you know, you could use any kind of gravel you have. And so that on this, these are about 12 inches deep. And about for 10 inches, you want to have all this kind of gravel. You know, it's going to drain really well. If you use smaller gravel, then it could like clog up the system, especially if you're growing something like tomatoes where the roots go everywhere. It's not going to drain well. So the larger gravel they found works the best. First 10 inches. The last 2 inches, what you're going to use is the smaller gravel. So for the last 2 inches, you're going to use this smaller gravel. And the reason for the gravel that may be a challenge for some is when you're digging through this gravel, this stuff is actually kind of sharp and it could end up cutting you. But the gravel is really cheap. The other thing that people use for this is what they would also use in hydroponics. And that's this stuff right here. These are called hydroton balls. And these hydroton balls are very, very expensive. So it's much less expensive to buy the gravel. But you know, these ones are good if you don't want to get your hands cut up, because you can just dig through these and they're cool. Plus they look cool, but I don't know, I like the look of the gravel better. One of the critical parts to this system, actually, they found is the worms. They're using blue Jamaican worms. You could also use red wiggler worms, but I like blue Jamaican worms. And no, blue Jamaican worms are not blue, unfortunately. They're still pink. But they're a special kind of composting worm as well, but they put those in here, which basically the worms add the bacterial aspect of this whole system and add more nutrients. And you know, worms will break down rocks. Sounds funny, you know, but yes, worms will basically gnaw away at the rocks. They'll also eat all the other debris that the fish eat that the plants don't eat. Plus they'll make more nutrients for your plants. So the worms are definitely an essential part of this aquaponic system. We could dig around down in here and oh, the water's actually filling up now because we're on the fill cycle. But we could dig in there and we'd find a whole bunch of the Jamaican blue worms. So the aquaponic system is very easy. Basically, you have the tank with all the fish in there, which is then sucking the water up through a pump and pumping the water out. And this pump basically pumps out the water up and circulates the water 5 times per hour. It's on a 10-minute fill, so it takes 10 minutes to fill it up. And then it takes 2 minutes to suck it out or to siphon all the water out. So they're putting water in, then siphoning it out, and they're using what's called bell siphons to do that. And that's how easy it is to get this system going. One of the other benefits of this aquaponic system is that, you know what, you don't have to bend down. So it's like a raised bed system. These are raised off the ground. Of course, you could have them on the ground, but to make the plumbing easier and to make it so that you don't have to bend and strain your back, they raised them up. So it's real simple how they did it. They just got some pier blocks and put the pier block down. And they put you know, some more wood on top, and they just have these nice, looks like 4x6s going across the top, where all these 40-gallon feed troughs sit on with all the rocks. So, I mean, these guys, oh man, these are really heavy. So this is supporting a lot of weight. They just basically got 4 pier blocks with the 4x6 to support it. And then as you can see underneath here, this is where they run all the piping. So this also makes access to all the piping really easy, so you could do any repairs or just to install it real simple when it's all elevated off the ground. It's going to save your back and be a lot easier to work. So just like any gardening project, you're going to learn as you grow. So not everything's always going to work out right, you know, and work and grow perfectly the first time. And that's what's happening here. You know, he was having some problems with the fish, maybe not, you know, living, and they died off for some reason, and he didn't know why that was happening. So basically what he got told was to add this. This is a EM1, or effective microorganisms. And so not only can you add this to the water, which will then add it to the water, which will give the fish beneficial microbes that'll keep them alive, it's also really good for plants. And actually this is sold actually as a plant nutrient. So I'd encourage everybody to actually look into EM1 and use that in your garden. It's definitely a good product and I would recommend it. So I've had a lot of fun here at the Mackay Inn, checking out and learning more about aquaponics. We're sitting here in their beautifully landscaped courtyard with a big rack. I mean, this thing must weigh, oh man, like 100 pounds of bananas ready to ripen up. And maybe when you're here, this will be ripe and you'll get to try some bananas off the tree. So if you want to learn more about the aquaponics going on here, please visit the website aquaponicsmaui.com. So once again, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and keep growing those fruits and vegetables.